Hi, this is Dan.
And I'm Ravi.
And before we get into this year's Retro Hour annual Christmas Super Quiz, this is our last episode of 2018.
Oh, it's so awesome. What a good year.
And we just want to take a quick minute before we get into the quiz just to say a big thank you to the people who make the Retro Hour podcast possible, have allowed us to do this all throughout 2018 and into 2019 as well. And they are our loyal donators. Now, this week, we just want to say a big thank you to Lawrence Benyon,
Falco,
Nigel Wilkinson,
and Andrew P. Jones,
who all made donations into the running of the show. And if you'd like to do that and help us out run the show into 2019, all you've got to do is nip onto our website at theretrohour.com. And we also just want to take a quick moment to give a big thank you to The Economist as well. Now, The Economist have been a really big supporter of our podcast over the last couple of months. And the thing is, before we started reading The Economist, I think just by the name, because it's been going so long, 170 years, The Economist has been out now. It's, you know, very well established. But by the name, I assumed it was going to be all about like the economy and finance and that kind of thing. But actually, it's bang on target for our podcast because there is lots of technology and video games articles in here too. Now, we've been reading about one called Patronia. It's kind of all about serious video games. It's like new genre that's coming around. I mean, there's one they're talking about here called The Fiscal Ship, where players get to try and cut America's public debt while meeting national goals. So they essentially get to play the president, really.
Yeah, it's really strange because if you remember Papers, Please,
that was
a really popular indie game, and it was kind of based around being an immigration officer in a kind of Eastern Bloc Soviet style. So getting it put into these positions that you'd never usually be in can actually be really fun. If you think about a lot of the games, like the early ones, you'd have stuff like SimCity, which would be a huge a building planning and kind of management game, and that just got absolutely massive. And Theme Park as well was a great one.
So if you want to read more about stuff like that, I mean, The Economist is fascinating. It really helps you prepare for what's going on in the world around you. And we'd like to give you a free copy of The Economist to say thank you for listening to the show, and so you can check it out for yourself as well. So if you want to get a free copy of The Economist, the smart guide to the forces changing your world, get your free copy right now by texting the word RETRO and sending it to 78070. So for your free print copy of The Economist, text RETRO and send it to 78070. Let's get into the quiz. Hello and welcome to the Retro Hour annual Christmas Super Quiz for 2018.
Oh yeah.
Come on, lads, how exciting.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Not at a funeral.
We are back.
Now we are. It's been a whole year since the last Retro Hour Super Quiz. Christmas time is here again. And I was saying, actually, you guys are a bit like Santa. We often only catch up at Christmas time, so.
True. We come but once a year.
Well, let's introduce the teams now. First of all, I'm your host. I'm Dan, full of cold. So if I mess the questions up, that's my excuse. Would. We have Ravi, blame it on the jet lag if I lose Abbott. And Joe was partying with groupies until 5 a.m. after his gig last night. So there we go. Excuses out the way. And let's welcome back the reigning champions.
Thank you.
Paul Drury and Oliver Wilmot, welcome back.
Thanks for having us.
Hello.
If my memory serves me correctly, I think you might have had a win last year, did you?
It's 2-0, so I don't know whether it's your turn or you're just gluttons for punishment. We'll see.
Well, Ravi went out for lunch before we came in today, and you've been doing a video games quiz at lunch.
Well, practicing on online ones, but I don't know if you got the questions from them. We'll see.
That's a good idea.
I'm not going to big myself up. Yeah. I know not to do that.
Yeah, well, I've checked the Google Doc. Ravi hasn't accessed it, so we're all good there. Now, I'm sure we're well versed in this by now, but let me quickly recap the rules of the way this is going to work. We will have 10 rounds of 10 questions about retro gaming. Each team will take alternate turns to answer a question. If you get it wrong or pass, it will be passed over to the other team. If I feel you're hesitating or taking a bit too long on a question, you'll hear a 10-second countdown that sounds like that.
Oh, Jesus.
That's when you get nervous and you're like... And then, pressure. Of course, if you don't answer by the end, it will be passed over to the other team. I will take your first answer, so no shouting out random things.
Turkey cheese.
And the lovely Anna is a scorekeeper this year. Now, she'll be marking you at the end of each round, and then the team with the most points at the end of the quiz will win.
Nice.
All clear? Anna, do you want to pick which team's going to go first?
Oh, what?
Start with Ravi and Joe. Give them a fighting chance. Right then, okay, here we go. Round number one. Ooh. Come on, lads. Good luck. Good luck, everyone. Now, round one, I thought I'd ease us gently into this with a bit of general knowledge. So, Ravi and Joe. Axel and Blaze are the main characters in which trilogy?
Streets of Rage.
Streets of Rage is correct. Paul and Ollie. What was the name of the light gun peripheral for the original Nintendo Entertainment System?
I
think it was. Was it called? Was it called something?
Yeah, it was like the Zapper.
The Zapper is correct. Ravi and Joe, name the 1993 sequel to the space trading game Elite.
Frontier.
Frontier is correct. Paul and Ollie, name the 1991 side-scrolling platformer developed by Core Design and featuring a caveman as the main character.
I think it's that, Ollie. Yeah. Chuck Rock.
Chuck Rock is correct. Ravi and Joe, what does the acronym NES stand for?
Nintendo Entertainment System.
Is correct. Ooh. Paul and Ollie, what is the name of the three Battletoads?
Oh, God. This is you.
Pimple.
You're going to know this.
Rash.
Mm-hmm. One more.
Zitz.
Yeah. Zitz is correct.
Yes. Well done.
Ravi and Joe.
I wasn't so sure.
Good guessing. Ravi and Joe, name the first commercial arcade game.
Oh. Commercial.
Pong?
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Then it's with great pleasure that I'm going to say Computer Space.
Computer Space is correct. Paul and Ollie, which console generation does the Sega Dreamcast belong to?
Oh, I hate these.
We had one similar last year. This is difficult. What console, sorry?
The Sega Dreamcast.
It's definitely after 5. Is it? Is it 8?
I don't know. That sounds a lot. So we've got the Tower in that is the first one.
Then you've
got
to hurry, guys.
7 or 8?
7. I don't know.
7th.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Let's go with 5th.
Incorrect. It was the sixth generation.
Oh, I wrote them both down.
All right.
Ravi and Joe.
One off.
Which famous football player appears on the cover of 2006's FIFA Street 2?
Oh.
It's hard. I lost.
I don't know footballers.
FIFA games.
I don't know footballers.
That's a hard one.
He's got dreadlocks. That's all I know.
You have to hurry up.
Wayne Rooney.
Incorrect. I'm gonna hand it over.
You go for it.
Right, hang on. Okay. I don't know if it's 2006.
I'm going to give this one to you. I do not know.
Could be that. Oh, it could be.
You said the one. I remember he was kind of skinny.
Sorry, that was as opposed to the fat footballers that we usually have.
Yeah. 10 seconds.
Go for it.
Oh, we don't know. Ronaldo.
Ronaldo's correct.
Yes.
And the final one in this round, then, for Paul and Ollie. Name the final boss in Golden Axe.
Oh, Death Adder.
Death Adder's correct. There we go. Round one over. Sweaty palms all round.
Scribbling.
They were great questions. I like that.
That was harder than last year.
Oh, we're just getting warmed up, boys.
Especially for our first round.
God, I don't think me and Ravi are even going to get 10 points.
So, Anna, what were the scores at the end of that round?
3 and 6.
Ravi and Joe have got 3.
Well done,
Paul
lads.
And Ollie have got 6. So the champions are in the lead again already.
That generation one was hard.
You can call it back though, boys. Yeah. Joe, I think you're going to like this one, Joe. Round number 2 is all about your favourite company. Should we do a round on Sega?
Please.
And we'll start with Ravi and Joe. The Dreamcast was released before or after the PlayStation 2?
Before the PlayStation 2.
That's correct. Paul and Ollie. Not including the D-pad.
Oh.
How many buttons are on the Sega Master System's standard controller?
Okay, we get a bit of time for this. Do you say not including the D-pad?
Not including the D-pad.
Okay. I think it's
the ones. It's not a.
It's not including the D-pad.
Yeah. Is there not a select?
Is there a select button? That's the question. I don't think there is. You know.
You think it's only that many?
I think it might be only 3.
Come on, guys. 10 seconds.
Well, Ollie's going to go for it.
Oh gosh, 3.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
4.
Incorrect. It is 2.
Because they're on the console.
They are, yeah. And when you start actually with one of the buttons, one of these select buttons as well, you see. Back in the day before they had it all figured out. Right then, Ravi and Joe, what were the names of Sega's first and last home video games consoles?
Well, that's the last one. But the first one's called
Was it this?
Yeah, so we think it's the SG-1000 and the Sega Dreamcast.
That is correct. Yeah. Paul and Ollie, before Sonic the Hedgehog, who was widely regarded as Sega's mascot character?
Is it this? Yeah, we agree. Alex Kidd.
Alex Kidd's correct. Ravi and Joe, what was the Mega CD known as in America?
Sega CD.
Correct.
I was like, it's not that easy.
Really had to think about that.
I was looking at Ravi, I was like,
I'm waiting for the trick question to come up.
Yeah.
There were no trick questions, I'm not that nasty. Okay, Paul and Ollie, how many Crazy Taxi games were released for the Dreamcast?
I think it's... because I think the third one came out. I'm not certain.
Oh, man. I think it might be one.
I'm sure that came out as well.
Come on, guys, 10 seconds.
We've got a disagreement here.
Shall I go for your one? Two.
Two is correct.
Ravi, second release for the music.
Glad I went with you then.
Thank you.
Ravi and Joe, name the battle axe wielding dwarf in Golden Axe.
Oh, no!
Everyone picked him.
It's...
come on then, 10 seconds.
Oh, man.
Gary?
I'll hand it over. Paul and Ollie?
Do you think it's the name of the...
what's the name of the battle axe-wielding dwarf in Golden Axe? 10 seconds on the clock, Paul and Ollie.
Axe Battler?
Incorrect, it was Gilius Thunderhead.
Oh.
Okay, Paul and Ollie. How many bits is the Sega Saturn?
Isn't it that? 32?
32 is correct. Ravi and Joe. In 1991, Sega released a Laserdisc arcade game written by Dragon's Lair creator Rick Dyer, which featured a hologramic effect. What was that game called?
I think it's...
and 10 seconds on the clock.
Something Dome.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Something like that.
Okay.
Shall I go for that?
Between, yeah.
Time Traveller.
Time Traveller is correct.
Yes. Nice one.
Okay, last one in this round then for Paul and Ollie. Which year was Sega founded? 1915, 1952 or 1960?
Yes, definitely.
Is it our question?
Your question.
Oh, okay. 19... Ooh, that was close.
You're going to hand over the question, were you?
No, 1952.
Okay, I'm going to hand it over.
1960.
1960 is correct, in Honolulu, Hawaii. So there we go, the end of round two. All about Sega. We're getting there, boys.
Yeah. They're creaming us. I think they're on like 13 or something.
That was quite even, but we were three ahead from
the
first round.
Yeah, I think they're
on the end of that round, what the scores? So the end of round two, 10 to Paul and Ollie, 7 to Ravi and Joe. You're doing all right this time, boys. Not too far behind.
I know. Yeah. We actually got a question where we both guessed one half and it was correct.
Teamwork.
Collaboration.
There's a lot of shoulder rubbing and stuff going on over here.
I see you holding Ravi between rounds. Okay, then so round number three. And this one is going to be all about video games consoles. We've all got plenty of games consoles, haven't we?
Yeah.
Okay, we'll start with Paul and Ollie. Name the only Atari Jaguar game that you could play with the VR helmet accessory.
Oh.
That's difficult.
Was it that one?
Sorry, bang the mic.
Oh, it's not eight. Oh, my God.
I don't
God.
Think it's that.
Go. Okay, my guys, 10 seconds.
Battle Morph?
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Was it Tempest?
2000?
Incorrect, it was Missile Command.
Oh, God.
Ravi and Joe, which game publisher distributed the Sega Master System in the UK after its launch?
Mastertronics.
Is correct.
Oh, okay.
Paul and Ollie, which Sega console had the code name Project Mercury?
Oh.
10 seconds on the clock.
I don't know. Ollie, you're...
32X?
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Was it the Dreamcast?
Incorrect. It was the Game Gear.
That wasn't even our second guess.
All right, Ravi and Joe. This console was initially produced by Panasonic in 1993 and was named Time Magazine's Product of the Year. Which console was it?
One of them too.
10 seconds.
3DO.
3DO is correct.
Oh.
Paul and Ollie. Which console used a custom CD format called GD-ROM?
I think that's right.
Yeah. Dreamcast.
Dreamcast is correct. Ravi and Joe, which console was the first to offer HDMI output out of the box using full 1080p? It's very modern
fashion. Xbox 360.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Oof, quite a minute. So we thought it might be that as well.
Too modern for Joe, that question.
Well,
HDMI okay. out of the box.
HDMI, what's that?
Afterwards? I don't...
Yeah, because...
Oh.
And then pull on Ollie, 10 seconds.
Unless it... All right, with PS3?
PS3 is correct. Ooh. Okay, pull on Ollie.
I'm surprised, actually.
What does the VCS in Atari VCS stand for, pull on Ollie?
Oh, great. Sorry. It's just video computer system.
It's correct. Ravi and Joe, which sixth generation console used 8-centimeter optical discs?
The GameCube.
GameCube's correct. Pull on Ollie. The original Xbox could play DVDs out of the box, true or false?
No, it doesn't, because you'd need a controller to play them.
It's correct.
Well done.
And the last one in this round then, for Ravi and Joe, who designed the neon light synthesizer in the Xbox 360?
Jeff Minter.
Jeff Minter's correct. Yeah. There we go, the end of round number three.
Oof.
So at the end of round three, it is 11 to Ravi and Joe and 14 to Paul and Ollie.
Yeah, good question.
It's quite tense, because it's a lot harder.
It's hard, isn't it?
I like the Xbox one, because the Xbox original was like 720p, wasn't it?
He's trying to get bonus points. Put me on this one. It's not working.
if you modded it, it could be 720p.
Yeah. That's where the Xbox Media Center thing started on that, didn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, but not fully 1080 yet.
That is not one of the questions, though. Right, okay, so round number four. Let's chill out a little bit. A bit more general knowledge.
This is too close.
Yeah, you boys are looking a bit nervous.
Mm, we are.
Ravi and Joe, you fancying a win?
I don't know.
we're all winners.
Never tasted it before, so
okay. I don't know what winning looks like.
Paul and Ollie, on September the 13th, 1993, saw a very popular arcade fighting game get a global world home console release. What was the marketing name given to this day?
Mortal Monday.
Mortal Monday is correct. Yeah. Ravi and Joe, which unreleased computer was the design of the PlayStation 2 based on?
Oh, you know this. You've told me about this.
Yeah.
I only know this because of Rap. Well, I don't know it, but he's told me.
PlayStation 2.
10 seconds.
Yeah, it's a Japanese, like, standing up. I can see it.
Is it the PSX?
Incorrect. No, I'm going to hand it over. Paul and Ollie.
What's you say?
Do you need the question again?
I mean, it looks like a monolith, but go for the question
again. Okay. Which unreleased computer was the design of the PlayStation 2 based on?
I don't know. I mean, if it's Japanese, it might be that company, but is this a thing?
No, that's just the
You've
space
just on 10 seconds.
Go for that one.
Right, we don't really. We think it might be an NEC.
Incorrect. It was the Atari Falcon Microbox. There you go.
Yeah, wow. Definitely.
Well, we've all learned something.
I've got two of them.
That's cool.
Paul and Ollie. Resurrection Rise 2 was the 1996 sequel to which fighting game?
Isn't it this? That awful.
Yes, Rise of the Robots. Yeah.
Since you said awful one, everyone knew it was.
Yeah,
correct.
The rubbish one.
Okay, question four to Ravi and Joe. Not including the D-pad. How many buttons are on a standard GameCube controller?
Okay.
Oh. I'll give you a bit of time on this one. Have a slurp of my eggnog. Oh, strong.
Is that actually eggnog? So, I'm in a bit of a situation because we have the start button, the left button, the right button, the Z button, the X, the Y, the A, the B, and the C stick. Now, is the C stick one button?
Or is it a stick?
Or is it a stick? And then we have the analog and the D-pad.
Come on, give me an answer.
So, you can't click the C stick.
He said no D-pad, so
everything.
Go on, 7 seconds.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
I think he should have really helped us, but I don't know which one of those is wrong.
I just described these.
Throwing you off the scent. Go on, I'll recap the question. Not including the D-pad, how many buttons are on a standard Nintendo GameCube controller?
I've just drawn it.
All right, you sure it's not? All right. Go for it.
Good, then 10 seconds.
Eight.
Eight's correct.
How is that? Is that minus the C stick and the analog stick?
Yeah, they're the buttons.
Okay. I actually hate you.
There's a button that's a Z, right? I only remember.
Yeah, just
there's that weird one in the corner, isn't there? Yeah. It's only got one shoulder.
Like,
yeah.
Come on, man. I drew it.
Okay, Paul and Ollie. In the 1993 movie Super Mario Brothers, what was Mario and Luigi's surnames revealed to be?
I think I know this one.
Mario,
right?
Yeah, surely it's because they're the Mario.
It's Mario.
Mario is correct. Mario. Ravi and Joe, what is the title of the first game in the Halo series?
Halo Combat Evolved.
Is correct. Paul and Ollie, which two systems was Sonic Chaos released on in 1993?
Okay, so is it... That's one. What was the other one?
It was on two... Oh, Game Gear and Master System.
Is correct. Ravi and Joe, which year did the Sony PlayStation get released in the UK?
In the UK? Ooh. Yes. Do you want to go for that?
I'll 10 seconds. Pick. Yeah.
We're going to go for 1994.
Incorrect. I'm going to have
it's not, to be fair, it's 95.
95 is correct.
We knew it came out in 94, but we're like...
94, really late in Japan.
Really, yeah. Really late.
1994.
We both wrote 94. I was like, is it 95?
Okay, Paul and Ollie, which year was the Sony PlayStation discontinued in the UK?
Oh, wow.
That's tricky. Mm. So
they released FIFA games so PS4, late afterwards.
So I think it's quite late.
PlayStation 1?
Yeah.
And you counted the PS1?
We'll count the PS1.
The little dinky one.
I'm not really sure, you know. I think you go for this.
I'm still reviewing games like this one. I reckon it's late.
And then 10 seconds.
Or maybe that. Yeah, which one?
Go for that one, yeah.
It's your turn, so you choose.
2005?
I'll hand it over.
2002?
Incorrect, 2006.
Oh, that was
so close.
And the last one in this round, to Ravi and Joe. What name do Nintendo use for their customizable avatars?
And me.
Me's correct.
Yeah.
And at the end of round four, the scores are 13 to Ravi and Joe and 20 to Paul and Ollie. It's normally this bit in the quiz where a bit of a turnaround, isn't it?
Yeah.
I hope not.
Years. Like, so ace attorney turnaround.
I'm having it.
Because
now we're at round number five. Now, the last question went to Ravi and Joe, so we'll start with Paul and Ollie in this round. And this round is all about the biggest video games company in the world. Let's have a round about Nintendo.
Okay,
question number one, Paul and Ollie. Which Nintendo series is the character Ridley featured in?
Of course.
Metroid.
Metroid's correct. Ravi and Joe. Mario's rival Wario made his first appearance in which game? Full title.
Is it Wario World?
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Okay, so I'm going to say this, and then that's the second bit of it. You, Ollie, I know it's my turn, but you say it.
Oh, you're right.
And
yes,
10
go
seconds.
For that. You go for it, yeah.
Super Wario Land. Do you need the colons?
What was that? Super what?
Oh.
I know what it is, Dan.
Go on.
Can you say it? Say it.
The rules! The rules!
It's Mario Land.
Okay, I'm not going to let you have that. I'm going to... It is Super Mario Land 2, 6 Golden Coins.
Oh,
is a full
title.
Oh,
we're all wrong.
To be fair, I wrote that, but I wrote Wario Land.
Yeah. Okay. Close. Okay. But no cigar. Right, then Paul and Ollie. What's the name of Star Fox's battleship?
Isn't it just that? Is it... Oh, sorry, who's it?
It's you two.
Yeah, isn't it that?
Come on, 10 seconds.
What was it? Is it that? Starwing?
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
God. Oh, is it?
That's the name of the solar system. I'm thinking Lilac, but that's the name of the...
It is Great Fox.
Oh, right.
I never gave an answer.
You can't say I was going to say this.
I'm
is it
thinking
right?
this. I'm talking to my partner here. Fair.
Okay. Ravi and Joe, which console was Super Mario Sunshine released on?
GameCube.
GameCube's correct. Paul and Ollie, what is the first game with Princess Zelda as a playable character?
Oh, now this is a tough one.
Isn't that a CDI game, right? Oh, I shouldn't say too many.
Well, I know that.
Go on, I don't.
Should I go for it?
Come on, yeah, 10 seconds.
For it, I don't.
Is it called Zelda's Adventure?
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
It's called... something... I can see it right now. I watched a video on it the other day. I can see it. I can see it.
If it's in your mind's eye, that's not my answer.
Go on.
Go on, Joe.
Oh, man. Zelda's Quest. I don't know.
Zelda Wand of Gamelon.
Wand of Gamelon. I was thinking Wand of Camelot, and I was like, this isn't right.
Okay, Ravi and Joe. Which Mario Kart game features two riders per kart?
Double Dash.
That's correct. Paul and Ollie. What was Nintendo's original line of business when the company was founded in 1889?
This one I can do. They made Hanafuda cards.
Yes, playing cards have got Hanafuda. Well done. Okay, Ravi and Joe. What was the first SNES game to use the Super FX chip?
Oh, was it... It depends what region it came out in, but we're either going for... No. It was either Star Fox or Star Wing.
Which one are you going for?
Well,
Star Fox, you said first. That's correct, though. Okay, Paul and Ollie. What was the Super Nintendo known as in South Korea?
Oh.
You're going to go, yeah. Oh.
I didn't know
South
this.
South Korea? Really?
That's just a Super Famicom.
It can't be. Has it got like a funky name? Like?
Come on, boys. 10 seconds.
Right.
Super Famicom.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
In South Korea?
This is a crazy question.
Nintendo 2.
No, it was called the Super Comboy.
Fair.
And the final one
tougher
then.
Tougher than GameCube, right?
Yeah.
Final one in this round to Ravi and Joe. Which leading computer graphics company did Nintendo partnership with when making the N64?
Oh,
I'm in 10 seconds.
SGI, Silicon Graphics.
Is correct.
Yeah.
Right then, so the end of that, 17 to Ravi and Joe, 22 to Paul and Ollie. You think it's a bit tougher this
23,
year?
23, right?
Mm. Said it everyone, didn't I, on our little Facebook group that it was going to be tougher.
Wrapped
you didn't believe
it. Up, wrapped it up, wrapped it up.
It's great.
Right then, well, this is a one, actually. Probably a bit of a bad timing in the quiz for you lads. Normally where you fall down this one, Ravi and Joe, isn't it? Computers.
Oh, bloody hell.
Round
console
number six
boys,
is all about computers.
It's
yeah,
not my first
console
computer.
Lads. Okay, so we'll start this round with Paul and Ollie. Atari released their two first home computers in 1979. What were their model numbers?
Yeah, got this. Should I do this? It's the Atari 400 and the Atari 800.
It's correct. Ravi and Joe, what did the initials of the Sinclair QL stand for?
Quantum light.
I'm going to hand it over.
Do you want to say it?
Quantum leap.
Quantum leap's correct.
Yeah. Unlucky lad.
No, that was a quantum.
Close. Yeah. Okay, question three for Paul and Ollie. Microsoft released two versions of Windows in the year 2000. One was Windows 2000, obviously. What was the other?
Oh, okay.
I think so.
Windows, is it me or ME?
ME.
Yeah, correct.
Yeah.
Windows ME. Question four for Ravi and Joe. Which British computer company owner won a knighthood for services to British industry in 1983?
Alan Sugar?
Incorrect, I'm going to hand
no,
it over.
No, the computer company.
The owner.
Sorry, yeah. Sir Clive Sinclair.
Clive Sinclair's correct.
What does that say? What does that say?
bad luck.
Okay, question five to Paul and Ollie. Who purchased...
Purchased.
Question five. Who purchased the Spectrum and Sinclair brand in 1986?
No, he wasn't
I tried to keep a straight face.
He wasn't a sir then, but it was Alan Sugar.
Alan Sugar is correct.
Piss take.
All right, question six to Ravi and Joe. Which British computer company produced the Electron in 1983?
Acorn.
Acorn's correct.
Thank you, Ravi.
And this one to Paul and Ollie. What does the computer acronym WIMP stand for?
You go for this, I'm not sure. Well, I don't know.
Music.
You've told me this before. WIMP.
Get sand kicked in your face.
Right.
Go for it.
So Windows Amplifier?
Incorrect, I'm going to hand it over. What does the computer acronym WIMP stand for?
Windows
internal machine protocol.
Windows, icons, menus, pointers.
Oh, God.
Okay.
That's so 90s. Right.
Yeah, so 90s.
All right, question 8 to Ravi and Joe. The Office Assistant introduced an animated paperclip character to Office users with Office 97 to 2003. What was his name? I'll accept two variants.
Clippy.
Clippy, or Clippet, yeah. Commonly known as Clippy. All right, question 9 to Paul and Ollie. Which company invented the concept of the GUI?
I think I know this.
What do you I was going to say these, but... Oh, no, it's not. It's that.
Come on then, guys, 10 seconds.
What?
Come on, 10 seconds.
Computer company.
Go on then.
Well, I'm really sorry if he's right, but Apple.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Xerox
is correct.
Oh, Ollie, I'm sorry.
I wasn't.
And question
really
number
sorry.
10, last one in this round then to Ravi and Joe. What was the name of Microsoft's CD-based encyclopedia?
Encarta.
Encarta's correct.
Go on, Ravi, we've got three of them.
And at the end of round number 6 then, the scores are Ravi and Joe, 21, and Paul and Ollie, 27. You're in the 20s, though, lads. You're getting there.
We're getting there.
Okay, now the next one. Come on, we all remember going to the arcades when we grew up.
Oh, blue. Oh, these two get out.
Oh, I love arcade games.
Finally, our misspent youth will come in handy.
Rubbing his hands. Right then, okay, let's start round number 7, all about arcades. And we'll start with Paul and Ollie.
Oh, what? They went first.
you're the last question in the last round.
Okay. No, we didn't. Did we? I don't know. Yeah.
Okay. In the classic Atari game Centipede, what appears when you shoot at the centipede once?
I'm going to say mushroom toadstool. I mean,
mushrooms, correct. Yeah, right. Okay. Question 2 cool. to Ravi and Joe. What are the names of the dragons in the game Bubble Bobble?
Bob and Bob.
Bob and Bob's correct. Paul and Ollie. In the video game Donkey Kong Jr., who is holding Donkey Kong captive?
Mario.
Mario's correct. Yeah.
He's Jumpman in that.
No,
he's Mario by the end.
He was Jumpman in that. He's by that point. He's
Save it till the end, lads. Save it till the end. We're on the clock. Okay, question 4 to Ravi and Joe. In the 1991 Konami arcade game The Simpsons, what is Marge Simpson's primary weapon?
It's a vacuum cleaner.
That's correct. Question 5 to Paul and Ollie. What was the name of the urban legend arcade machine that supposedly was part of a government-run psychology experiment in Portland, Oregon in the early 80s?
It was Polybius.
Polybius is correct. And question 6 to Ravi and Joe. In which arcade game would you assume the role of agents Thomas Rogan and G?
House of the Dead.
House of the Dead's correct.
Nice.
Paul and Ollie.
G.
How was colour achieved on some versions of Space Invaders that had monochrome displays?
Yeah,
an overlay on the screen.
So we sort of answered this, Patrina. They put cellophane on the screen, different coloured cellophane.
That's correct, with coloured cellophane. Ravi and Joe. How many playable characters does the original 1994 arcade release of Tekken feature?
Oh, man. Come on.
Come on, Joe, this is your forte.
The original, the arcade.
1994 arcade release of Tekken.
How many playable characters?
How many playable characters? Go on then, 10 seconds.
Oh, man. 12.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Okay, I don't know if it included unlockables.
I was about to say there's unlockables, but I think we're going to go for...
In terms of the start screen, you're kind of saying.
We'll go for 8.
8's correct.
Yeah.
Oh. Okay. I was trying to write them all down and I start panicking.
Why don't you draw them?
I draw Nina over here.
Same as Street Fighter 2, I think.
Okay, Paul and Ollie, question number 9. Who's the final boss in Mortal Kombat 2?
Oh, in the second one,
in 10 seconds.
Shao Kahn.
Is correct. And the last one in this round then, to Ravi and Joe. What are the names of the twin brothers in Double Dragon?
Billy and Jimmy.
Is correct. At the end of round number 7, the scores are Ravi and Joe 25, Paul and Ollie 33.
Some chocolate.
A little bit of a sugar boost
we're
Joe.
We're drowning, I'm sorry.
Hey, we've still got 3 rounds left, you can bring it back. And the team's now currently getting a bit of chocolate just to get energy levels back up.
The food of gamers.
Before we start on round number 9, which is all about the Sony PlayStation. Ooh. Now, the PlayStation.
We've got this.
Console we're all very fond of, obviously. Last question, the last round was to Ravi and Joe, so this round we'll start with Paul and Ollie. Question number 1. The PlayStation was originally going to be a CD add-on unit for which console?
The Super Nintendo.
Is correct. Ravi and Joe. What was the first game to require the use of a dual analog DualShock controller?
I don't know.
You tell me.
Ape Escape.
Ape Escape's correct. Oh. Paul and Ollie. What is the name of the fruit collected by Crash Bandicoot?
No. The clueless look on your face.
Come on, 10 seconds.
You know?
Is it a made up fruit? Apple?
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Is it a Wampa fruit?
Wampa fruit's correct.
I put Umba.
Nearly. Okay, question 5 to Ravi and Joe. In the very first Uncharted game, Nathan Drake is looking for which treasure? Ten seconds.
I thought you meant the first PlayStation. None of this PS3 bollocks. The lost treasure.
Incorrect, I'm going to hand it over. It was lost.
Is it that one from Indiana Jones? I don't know.
It's something to do with Drake, his namesake. It's
really?
Sir Francis
Drake. 10 seconds.
He's Sir Francis Drake's ship. Something to do with Drake, no, isn't it?
El Dorado it was.
Oh, for God's sake.
Nothing to do with the awful
early
90s.
Never played any of them.
Who knows? Me neither.
Okay. Question 5 to Paul and Ollie. What was the name of the camera that was released for the PlayStation 2?
It was that.
The iToy.
iToy's correct. Ravi and Joe. The main character of Final Fantasy VII, Cloud, uses which weapon?
Is it the Buster Blade? The Buster?
I'll let you have that. It was a Buster Sword, yeah.
Yeah.
I'll let you have that. Okay, question 7 to Paul and Ollie. What's the name of the villain in Spyro the Dragon? Come on, 10 seconds.
I don't know, Paul.
I don't know.
Mario!
I'll hand it over, boys.
Ravi's wrote shitto. Could be. But I don't think that's right.
I think a lot of people probably yelled that at the TV when playing the game.
Not a clue.
But no, it was Nasty Nork. Gnasty Gnork, actually, spelled with G's.
Wow.
Okay, so question 8 in this round goes to Ravi and Joe. What was the name of the development kit for the PlayStation that looked like a black PlayStation?
Net Euros.
That's correct. Oh. Question 9 to Paul and Ollie. What was the name of the main city in Resident Evil 2?
Raccoon City.
Raccoon City is correct. Last one in this round then. Question 10 to Ravi and Joe. What was the best-selling game for the original PlayStation console?
That is hard.
That is very hard. The best-selling... I've got like the top 5 in my head, and I don't know which.
We only need one.
I don't know which. I'm going to go for Final Fantasy VII.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
I don't think. I thought it was that.
Okay, go for it.
Right, we don't know. I'm glad they got it wrong. Possibly Gran Turismo.
Gran Turismo is correct. Oh, it sold 10.85 million copies.
I think Final Fantasy VII's up there, but
I wasn't sure. Mm-hmm.
So at the end of round 8, the scores are 29 to Ravi and Joe, 37 to Paul and Ollie.
Well done, lads.
Keeping that gap there, though, but there is 2 rounds left.
Have you got a sound effects one? Are you doing noises?
Sound or music.
Identify this sound effect. No, actually, round 9 is all about... This is a new round, actually. We've not had this in the quiz before.
Uh-oh.
This is about video games and movies.
Oh, OK.
Ooh. So, question 1, Paul and Ollie. Bob Hoskins starred as Nintendo's famous plumber Mario in 1993 Super Mario Brothers, but who played his brother Luigi?
Oh, God.
He was in Usual Suspects.
I can tell you films he was in.
Right one, Dad.
Really?
And then 10 seconds.
Don't know.
Who played Luigi?
I don't know.
I'm going to hand it over.
I can tell you loads of names. He's an Italian bloke. He might be Italian.
Well, typecast.
Can I list you off like 5 films?
No.
Come on, give us an answer.
His name's like John Leguizamo.
John Wick?
He was in Ice Age. He played the sloth.
John Leguizamo was his name.
I was quite John.
Okay, question two, Ravi and Joe. Angelina Jolie was the original silver screen Lara Croft, but which British actor played her male co-star in the 2001 movie Lara Croft Tomb Raider?
Chris Barry.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Oh, I don't really know.
I thought it was Chris Barry. Yeah.
What the...
what was the question again?
Like the book.
Do you want that again? Angelina Jolie was the original silver screen Lara Croft, but which British actor played her male co-star in the 2001 Lara Croft Tomb Raider movie? Butler.
If the coast, is it Michael Caine?
Correct, it was Daniel Craig.
Oh, right.
Okay. Question three.
We were on about the butler, weren't we?
That's what
butler.
The butler. Yeah.
Okay, question three to Paul and Ollie. Which Mel Gibson movie was released as a platform game in 1992 by Ocean?
I think it's that.
Lethal Weapon.
Is correct. Ravi and Joe, which 1984 Activision game based on a blockbuster movie saw the player setting up a franchise in a city with a rising psychokinetic energy level?
Ghostbusters.
Is correct. Paul and Ollie, which action hero starred as the lead in the 2005 movie Doom?
Dwayne The Rock Johnson.
Is correct.
I think that's what he went by at the time as well. Good stuff.
Ravi and Joe, the 1994 movie Street Fighter starred which popular female singer?
Oh, Kylie Minogue.
Kylie Minogue's correct. Question seven to Paul and Ollie. Which 1989 Ocean-produced movie license game saw the player fight his way through the Axis chemical plant?
Oh, yeah.
One 10 seconds.
Do you think it's that?
We'll try that. RoboCop.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Batman.
Batman, yeah, Batman's correct.
Yeah, of course.
Okay, question number eight to Ravi and Joe. What was the last Harry Potter game to be released on the original PlayStation?
Oh, well, that is hard.
Yeah, I think that's it.
Goblet of Fire.
Incorrect, I'm going to hand it over.
Okay, so if we're assuming that they've done one in every... Oh.
10 seconds.
Maybe it
Do you
was,
think it's that?
I don't know.
what's his name?
Shall I go for that?
Come on, last second.
One's called Quidditch Cup.
Incorrect, it was a Chamber of Secrets.
Oh, right,
okay, that. Question number nine to Paul and Ollie. Which video game got a 1994 live-action movie starring Mark Dacascos and Scott Wolf as the lead characters?
I forgot the question already.
Was it? Oh, break, yeah.
Do you think so?
Double Dragon?
Double Dragon's correct. Last one in this round then, before we get into the last round of the quiz. Question 10 to Ravi and Joe. Name the 1997 N64 game where the player assumed the role of a British secret intelligence agent.
GoldenEye.
Yeah. You'd have got that wrong, Joe. I'd have been like, come on. Like, you know, your favourite game ever.
We were just like looking at each other like, nah, it's not that.
GoldenEye is correct.
The question was worded so perfectly.
Yeah. It throws you off, like.
And at the end of round number nine, the scores are 33 to Ravi and Joe, place 40 to Paul and Ollie.
Lose, basically.
Right? We've done slightly better because this time last year, you'd already won.
Yeah, this is still doable.
More consistent.
Okay. Deep breaths, everyone. Are we ready for the last round in the 2018 Retro Hour Christmas Super Quiz?
Yep.
We need a little bit of a heartbeat. Come on.
Can we do something epic?
Oh, gosh. Yeah. I'm scared.
Okay. This one is a return to general knowledge. Nice, easy questions for the last round. Paul and Ollie, the original Contra was famous for creating which cheat code?
Now, do you want just
you want
the
whole
name,
code,
or do you want how you do it?
The name of the code.
It's the Konami code.
The Konami code is correct. Ravi and Joe, name the 1983 Laserdisc arcade game which sees a character play the character of Dirk the Daring.
Dragon's Lair.
Dragon's Lair is correct. Paul and Ollie, what are the four ghosts called in Pac-Man?
Okay, they've got Inky, two names. Actually.
Blinky.
And the last one's Clyde.
Clyde.
But there's one before, Inky Blinky. What's the other one?
Inky Blinky Clyde.
That's, come on, 10 seconds. Rhymes with Inky and Blinky. Inky Blinky.
Oh, God, was it?
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H,
Come on. Pinky.
It's Pinky.
I bet that shield was gone before
the timer gone. I'm going to hand it over, guys. Name the four ghosts.
Inky, Blinky, Pinky, Clyde.
Is correct.
Oh,
you're so close. Okay, question number four to Ravi and Joe. In Super Mario Brothers, what is the first enemy that the player encounters?
A Goomba.
Is correct. Paul and Ollie, in emulation, what does MAME stand for?
I know this one. Multi arcade machine emulator. Multiple.
Yeah, that's correct. I'll let you
have
that one.
Thank you.
Okay, question six to Ravi and Joe. Pac-Man was originally known as what?
Puckman.
Puckman's correct. Paul and Ollie, what was Kirby's first game?
I don't know. So I'm guessing.
It was on the Game Boy.
That's it. These are only ones that I've known he was in.
What, Kirby's Dream Land?
And 10 seconds.
Kirby's Dream Land?
Is correct. Ravi and Joe, who does the player control in the game Ghosts and Goblins?
Sir Arthur.
Is correct. Paul and Ollie, which arcade game sees the character shooting insects in a mushroom patch?
Oh, what is that then, isn't it?
Yeah, you
Centipede.
Centipede's correct. Last one then in the quiz this year to Ravi and Joe. You'll get this one, no problem at all. What was the first games console capable of playing CD-ROM games with an optional add-on?
The Sega CD.
Incorrect. I'm going to hand it over.
Could you repeat the question, please?
Okay. What was the first games console capable of playing CD-ROM games with an optional add-on?
I think it was a PC Engine.
Go for it.
PC Engine is correct.
He's written it. He's wrote it down here as well.
And at the end of the Retro Hour annual Christmas Super Quiz 2018, the scores are Ravi and Joe 38. But our winner, once again, Paul and Ollie, have got 45. So that means you guys win the quiz again this year.
Well done.
Congratulations.
Can we just say, first of all, that was very close. But a bit like when Brazil won the World Cup three times, they got to keep it.
Yeah.
Right? Okay. So what me and Ollie would like to do, I'm sure your growing legions of fans that religiously listen to the Retro Hour would like to actually know who is the best between Dan and Ravi. So we would like to say, we would like to set the quiz next year. Dan and Ravi is captains. You can fight over that man, Joe, and then you'll have to recruit someone else. But how does that sound? We'll set it next year.
Okay. Yeah.
We'll write the questions.
So I don't get the safety of hiding behind the microphone and writing the questions.
Oh, no, Dan.
And mocking you when you get them wrong. It was so easy. All right, okay, challenge accepted. We'll do that next year. But congratulations, Paul and Ollie, the champions again for the third year in a row of the Retro Out Annual Christmas Super Quiz. You take the trophy again. Boys, what went wrong?
I don't know. I think we did pretty good. I don't think we really messed up too much in that one.
There
was an Alan Sugar Sinclair. Yeah. That was it. But
there was no shouty out moments.
Yeah, I think I genuinely think those guys, you know, Paul and Ollie, you just did better than us.
Magnanimous.
Honestly, like, from the bottom of my heart, I genuinely think we did really well, but I just think you guys just had the edge.
That's very nice.
Thank you. Very kind. Are you trying to get us on your side for when we set the quiz?
No, honestly,
for
the only one I'm a bit bitter about is the controller.
And don't you think they're both such handsome guys as well,
aren't
they?
Absolutely.
Yeah. Well, we're laying on the praise, you know, for next year. Right. But guys, honestly, congratulations. And this is our last episode of 2018, isn't it?
Yeah.
We need a week off after that.
Definitely, but we've got some good people coming up, definitely. What is it? Robbie back from Microsoft.
Yeah, Xbox special start of next year, but enjoy Christmas. Take it nice and easy. Play a lot of video games. Eat too much food. Drink too much, the standard. And we'll see you in 2019 on the Retro Hour podcast. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.